My friend, welcome to Breakfast with Sergio. In today's episode, I want to talk to you about, you know, how to grab your audience attention to be able to sell art. Well, my friend, welcome back to Breakfast with Sergio. I am very happy to be here with you. Welcome to my table. On my plate this morning, I have something super healthy. I have yogurt with papaya and blueberries and chia seeds and honey and some nuts as well. Super good, great way to start my day. Well, my friend, today I want to talk to you really quickly about, you know, how to grab your audience attention so that you can then sell art, promote your art, or whatever you want to do with that attention. Once you have that attention, you can do whatever you want with it, right? That's what it is. You may have 1 million followers, but if nobody's watching, nobody's paying attention, what's the use? So I want to talk a little bit about that, and I'm gonna start with a story because this one's pretty cool. So this was in 2012. It was around this time in 2012, and I was thinking I should do something about the fact that I love to paint large paintings, you know, really big ones. You know, you can see some in the back right there. Those big ones are mine, and you know, and much bigger. Those are actually, I consider those medium size. For me, those are medium. You know, I like to paint big. So I was thinking, well, you know, I want to give an opportunity for people who cannot afford those big things to also own and to have work of mine, you know, an original work of mine, not just a print, but an actual work. So I was thinking about that, and I said, well, you know, it's the end of the year. People usually buying gifts and buying things for themselves and to give to others and so on. So I said, what if I do something like a series of small works, but with a story around it that I can use to grab the attention of people and then offer what I have for them, you know, what I want to sell them, which is the small work. So I came up with this idea that I called 41 Winter. So the idea is, like, I was 41 years old, and I said, what if I do a small painting, you know, that it's celebrates each one of my years? You know, the idea was to make 41 of them. So I did, I went to the hardware store, I got, you know, a plywood, a couple of sheets of plywood, and they cut it for me into squares of 12 by 12 inches, or something about like this. And then I went to my studio and I started working, and I didn't want to do something realistic. I didn't want to do something figurative. I said, I'm going to just think about the idea of winter and be inspired by it. So they were all abstract. I even mixed coffee in some of the paint, and, you know, because in winter you drink a lot of coffee, and for me, winter is something that I never experienced until I was more like 16 years old, when I came to Chicago. Because in Mexico, where I live, Mexico City, you know, there was never snow. I never saw snow. You know, actually the changes of the year, you did not notice them too much until I came here, where I really experienced what cold weather really means. So I did this whole series that was called 41 Winters. And I actually making myself to do small scale work, you know, I challenged myself to do this small scale stuff that I really enjoy it so much, because I had never done something like that. But I said, well, 41 winters is cool, but I'm gonna make more because I'm really enjoying it. So I went to the hardware store, got more wood, ended up doing 64 pieces. I wasn't 64 years old, I was still 41, but I just enjoyed the process of that, that I ended up with 64 small works, and I called the show 41 Winters. I did a pop-up type of event, and I promoted it really heavily. There was a whole story about 41 Winters, what winter means to me. So I really produced a whole marketing plan around 41 Winters. I even created some really nice graphics for it to promote in my social media and so on. Back then, I don't think Instagram was around, but Facebook was around. And, you know, really made some nice promotions and sharing with everybody, and did a press release and did a whole lot of things all around the idea of 41 winters. Well, let me tell you, that idea actually worked really, really well for me. So I priced the work at a price point that was very accessible to most people, right? To most people, which was great. I think I sold each one at $150. So something super attractive, super, you know, accessible to most people, to most of my friends, family, and people that I knew. So out of those 64, I ended up selling during the event maybe about 75% of them. And then after the event, you know, I sold more because people sometimes came and say they bought one, and then they would say, well, Sergio, do you still have another one of those 41 winters? Because I got one, I would like to get a second one. And so by the end of the whole thing, you know, some months later, I ended up selling 90% or more of the thing. I only have like maybe four left around here at the house somewhere. So, you know, it was such an incredible experience, you know, to sell all that work and to meet so new people that were really excited to have one of my 41 winters, because they had never afforded, or, you know, one of those big giant paintings that I had been doing, the more expensive work. And it was a great opportunity because I never then did that again at that price point. So everybody who got works, maybe you got one if you're watching this video, I don't know. You know, this is work, it's an original work, Sergio Gomez, at a price point that, you know, was something that was really accessible, gave people a great opportunity. But what I learned about that experience is the power of marketing plan, creating a marketing plan around a specific idea, story, and really promoting it really heavily. It was so successful, the marketing plan, that even NPR, Chicago Radio, WBEC, you know, the National Public Radio here in Chicago station, they picked up the story, and they actually featured 41 Winters on a Friday during Worldview, you know, the show that they have called Worldview. And it was so cool, you know, they talk about, you know, my 41 winters and how, you know, this was this idea of me celebrating each one of my winters and how, you know, pretty much the whole story. And that was really cool. That was super awesome. So since then, since 2012, when I first did that, I've been doing this challenge for myself. And I take something that I want to do into small works. I've done anything from small paintings to drawings to things. Like even here, I have a couple. I have even done you know, digital, these were the iPad drawings. I did, 1 year I did a bunch of iPad drawings, and then I got them printed and mounted and with a little backing device so it could be hung on the wall or they could stand on a desk. And, you know, it's just been such a great, awesome experience. And I use that to grab the attention of the viewer, presenting with something that's affordable to them. And even if this, might not be very attractive to them, but they, because of this, they come and they can see also my larger work that I've done. And in fact, a lot of people that come and get a small work, then maybe years later or months later, they sometimes come and they are interested in some of the big ones. So again, it's a way to give an open door, an entryway into what I'm doing as an artist. So for the last 3 years, what I've been doing too is I've been inviting artists to do the challenge with me, you know, to join me. And I teach them how to do all the marketing, how to break it down into small sections week by week, you know, starting to think about what is it that we're going to do, how we're going to do it. Then we work really hard for a few weeks on growing our mailing list, you know, different strategies to grow our list, either to plan for an event or a social media event. In person or virtual, and then we actually start promoting, giving kind of teasers of what's coming and so on, and then we release all the works at the end of November, and then we sell them all the way to the end of December, and it's super cool. And I guide you through the whole process. I answer your questions, I help you out to think about ideas, you get to meet all the artists who are doing the challenge, and it's just been amazing for the last 3 years. So today, I want to invite you, if you want to do the challenge with me, and if you want to join us and get attention from your audience and be able to sell more art before the year is over, this is a great opportunity to do it without being salesy, without being weird and strange about selling, but really rather creating, contextualizing a story about the thing that you are doing as an artist, you know, about creating a narrative about you and your art that you can present to others. So if you want to join me, all you gotta do, my friend, is go to www.theartistnextlevel.com/smallworks. It's here on the screen, www.theartistnextlevel.com/smallworks, or just message me the word small works through Messenger, and I will send you a direct link if it's easier for you. But check it out. It's not free because I spend a lot of time coaching artists through it. But go to the link, you'll see all the details there. There's a frequently asked questions where, you know, if you have questions about what type of art and all that is answered in that page. So check it out. Hope you enjoy it. And I hope to see you in the Small Works Art Sale Challenge. Please share this episode with a friend and let's make 2019 our best year ever.